In our previous video, we learned a lot of things about linear functions. In this video, we're going to be learning about quadratic functions. The general formula for a quadratic function is of the form f of x equals ax squared plus bx plus c. We'll also call this y. The roots of a quadratic function are those numbers x for which f of x equals 0. So 0 equals ax squared plus bx plus c. And then we can use the well-known formula to find x1 and x2. This formula is minus p plus or minus the square root of p squared minus 4a times c, all this number divided by 2 times a. So when we plot a quadratic function, it has a U shape like this one. And here we can see the two roots, which will be called x1 and x2. A quadratic function can also be placed over the x-axis, and in this case it will only have one root, x1, which will equal x2. Let's see all this with an example. If we are giving f of x equal minus 3x squared plus 4x plus 1, let's try and find the root for this function. So we have to apply the formula we just learned. Here a equals minus 3, b equals 4, and c equals 1. So when we apply the formula, we'll be getting minus 4 plus or minus square root of 4 squared minus 4 times minus 3 times 1. All this number divided by 2a. And this is the number minus 4 plus or minus square root of 16 plus 12 divided by 2 times minus 3. This equals minus 4 plus or minus the square root of 28 divided by minus 6. So from here we get that x1 equals minus 4 plus the square root of 28 divided by minus 6. And x2 is minus 4 minus the square root of 28, all this divided by minus 6. Now let's learn a definition. Let's say we have a function f that goes from the real numbers into the real numbers. We're gonna say that f is even if f of minus x equals f of x for every x real number. Here the for every is very important. And f is odd if f of minus x equals minus f of x, again for every x in the real numbers. So let's see this definition with an example. If we define f of x to be equal to x squared, then when we try and evaluate f in 3 and minus 3, for example, what we get is that f of minus 3 equals minus 3 squared. This is 9. And f of 3 equals 3 squared, which is also 9. So we might think f is even. Let's try evaluating it in minus x. F of minus x equals minus x squared. And minus x squared equals x squared. And then x squared is our original function, f of x. So f of minus x equals f of x. Then f of x is even. Now with another example, if we take g of x, another function, equal to minus x squared, and we evaluated it in minus 3, it's minus 3 squared, which is minus 9. And she in 3 is minus 3 squared. This is again minus 9. So let's evaluate she in minus x and see what we get. She in minus x equals minus x squared. And this is minus x squared. And this is g of x. So again, g of x equals minus x squared is also even. Now let's see the importance of the number c in a quadratic function. The general formula for a function f is ax squared plus b plus c. So if we draw f equals to x squared, then we get this function. And now I can draw this other function, moving the f of x down one unit to get another function g of x that will be x squared minus 1. So the number c in this case moved our function down one unit. And if I try and draw the same function, but instead of moving it down, moving it up one unit, I will get this function, some h of x equals x squared plus 1. So with this example, we learned to move a function up and down. Let's see what can we do now to move it left or right. And these are called horizontal shifts. And what we're gonna do is study a specific type of quadratic function, y equals a times x minus h squared. This function is congruent to y equals ax squared, only that it is shifted h units to the sides. This shift is towards the right if h is greater than 0. And it's towards the left if h is smaller than 0. Let's see it with an example. We're given f of x equals minus 2 times x minus 3 squared. We know this f of x is congruent to minus 2x squared. Let's plot this g of x to get this function. Now the general formula we were talking about was a times x minus h squared. So in this case, h equals 3. And 3 is greater than 0. So the shift is to the right. So we have to move this function, we just draw 3 units to the right. And now draw it in the same place the other one was. Now let's say we're given another function, a function f of x equals minus 2 times x minus 3 squared plus 2. So from our green function we have to move 2 units in the y direction and now draw the same function we had, only in a different position.